Hi friends, when we start discussing about health and safety courses, the first safety course strike in our mind is IGC. In such way, it has got the highest attention and popularity after OSHA safety courses. Let us figure it out why IGC is so popular. What are the benefits with this course? How could be the examination system? What kind of tips we should follow in order to pass this exam in a simple way? Welcome to my channel, Health and Safety Training Tutorials. First, we discuss what is NABOSH and IGC. NABOSH stands for National Examination Board in Occupational Health and Safety. It is an examination board which was established in 1979 UK. It develops various vocational training courses for health and safety. IGC is a level 3 certification course, one of the most successful outcomes of NABOSH. Important note, we have two types of courses in NABOSH with similar name. The first one, NABOSH Award in Health and Safety at Work. Number 2, NABOSH IGC Level 3 course, the one which we are talking about. I will explain the difference between these two courses in the next video. Now we discuss why IGC course is so popular. All UK influenced countries and companies would recommend UK HSE courses because they believe that people who are certified with UK HSE courses may understand and implement the UK health and safety standards easily. IGC subject is very close to the conditions and activities of the working site. Any construction site, oil and gas plant, or any project is under UK people, then they surely expect UK-based HSE certifications from the employees. What are the benefits with IGC? You can get a job in Gulf countries, Canada and Asian countries in health and safety field. You can gain sufficient knowledge to work as a health and safety officer. You can be promoted to further levels by achieving high-level certifications in NABOSH followed by the IGC. Let us discuss about IGC course details. It totally contains 3 units or 3 papers. Unit 1, Management of International Health and Safety. Unit 2, Controlling Workplace Hazards. Unit 3, Health and Safety Practical Application. Unit 1 consisting the following: Principles of Health and Safety, Functions of ILO and Enforcement Agencies, Risk Assessment, Inspection, Auditing and Investigation. It discusses about health and safety regulations, codes, acts and its importance on a whole. Unit 2 consisting the following: This unit will give you sufficient practical knowledge and awareness to work in a working site. It covers all unsafe conditions, hazards, risks and precautions of all activities conducted in a working site. It discusses every point from general hazards to biological hazards in this unit. Unit 3 consisting the following: Students have to visit a working site and need to observe level of health and safety standards which are in place. They have to make a detailed report about site conditions, workers, welfare facilities, activities, hazards and precautions of the working site, which can be very useful to test their knowledge. Let us see what qualification is required for IGC course. Trainee should at least have intermediate, diploma or bachelor degree. English communication and writing ability is mandatory. At least they should write English sentences without mistakes. Working site experience or knowledge can be useful. Before attempting the IGC exam, students should follow a few conditions. First, students must change their perception that IGC is a tough exam. They should go to a working site and get some site experience. Use the exact terminology which is mentioned in the textbook. If the word hazard is mentioned in the textbook, then we must write the same terminology hazard in the exam. We cannot write any other word which has similar meaning like problem, issue or trouble. In general, IGC course is a 10 days program which contains 10 classes. Exam will be conducted immediate after to the classes. Therefore, students get very less time for preparation. Students have to take 1 month period gap for examination preparation. Contact your training institute for this option. Practice the key points in the textbooks and previous question papers as well. Now, let us discuss what are the advantages and disadvantages with IGC examination system. First, advantages. You can observe it's a very small course. Entire subject is fed in only two textbooks, which shows how easy it is. IGC 1 is very small, especially starting two elements, where you can gain very good marks easily. Understand the essence of the IGC by common sense, not theoretically. No need to write lengthy answers or filling the answer sheets as we do in our academic education. Just exact answer is required irrespective of the size. Marks will be given for correct answer, not for lengthy answers. Mandatorily visit a working site, observe all site conditions, activities carefully. Notice all the hazards, precautions, risk, control measures, welfare facilities and health and safety management system. Go through the internet. Lot of information is available about health and safety so that you can improve your knowledge and write better. Now, disadvantages. English communication is mandatory. No marks for irrelevant or similar answers. Time is limited. Course duration is 10 days, therefore it cannot be completed within the time for some times. If you are failed to understand the question correctly, then your answer goes wrong. Lengthy answers for tiny questions will not get you marks. If your writing is not understandable, then your exam is at risk. Now, tips for examination. First of all, you need to have self-confidence on yourself. Trusting ourselves is the primary key for success. Do not consider that IGC is like a rocket science. With good analysis and common sense, you can write it easily. Now come to the examination point of view. Split the exam into two parts for 20 marks question and 8 marks questions. Let us assume examination time is 2 hours. Allot first 30 minutes for 20 marks answer and rest of 1 hour 30 minutes time for 8 marks answer. Write the complete answers with simple one-line statements required for the marks. If you spend more time for easy answers, then you lose time for remaining answers. You have to use the same terminology which is mentioned in the textbook. Familiar words cannot gain you marks. To gain more marks easily, follow the key points mentioned in the textbook. You must attempt all questions to gain good marks rather than spending more time on simple answers. There are a few common points which you can see in every answer. Find and use them. Example: barrication, signages, fire extinguishers, supervision, documents like permits, risk assessment and emergency plan, etc. Use acronyms to remember the information easily, like PEMI, people, equipment, material and environment. KATE, knowledge, ability, training and experience. Prepare for exam with good commitment and focus, and write confidently, then success is yours. If you feel this video is useful, then share to everyone. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Many more interesting videos are coming soon. Keep watching Health and Safety Training Tutorials.